Dear students, welcome to EPG Parshala. In this module, we will discuss evolution of telecasting. Telecasting is a word that deals with the transmission of some information or some other form of content through a broadcasting medium like radio or television. It could be a video content. It could be some other signals. So in this module, we'll be discussing the history of telecasting in India, some of the broadcasting technologies that involved in production, distribution, and the exhibition, and also certain eminent personalities involved in the whole procedure. So we have discussed some of the points regarding the technology in another module. But we will briefly mention so that you will get an idea regarding the different areas and the relation between the different parts. So we have also incorporated those points in this module. So we start with some history and move on to the current one and then to important programs and technology. Hope that this module will give you a fair understanding regarding how telecasting has evolved over the years with the help of technology and content. During the 1950s, only a few thousand houses of the Western country had television sets. Now, this telecasting technology becomes part of every individual. Several scientists were working on the development of a technology which could transmit audiovisual information. In 1884, the first TV-related patent was given to a 24-year-old German inventor, Paul Nipkow. Paul Nipkow created the first rotating disc that would allow pictures to transmit over the wire. So here is a picture of John Baird, who is considered as the father of television, who is displaying his latest color televisor on the 17th of December 1942. During the 1920s, a number of scientists began experimenting with sending still images using radio waves. But many people acclaim John Baird as the father of television. In November 1936, BBC introduced the first regular public television service in the world. In 1939, television broadcasting started in the United States. During the 1930s and 40s, the telecasting technology gradually improved. After 1945, television sales in America dramatically increased. The early television broadcasts were all black and white. There were many limitations in the production of audio-video content. The first color program transmitted by Columbia Broadcasting System, CBS, in the US in 1953. Television came years later to the rest of the world. Since the 1970s till today, television has become the dominant mass medium. In the 1980s, satellite telecasting started and the people around the globe became more closer. Now, let us discuss the evolution of television from CRT to 4K. First one is cathode ray tube, that is CRT. It is a sophisticated vacuum tube in which images are produced when an electron beam strikes a phosphorescent surface. Most of the earlier television sets were based on this technology. In between 1960s and 2000, people used cathode ray tube CRT television set. Then flat screen sets like LCD or plasma started to appear in late 1990s. They were lighter and also take less space in respect to CRT set. Now, digital television. Analog becomes digital television with better picture quality. From 2006 to the end of 2012, the UK switched over from analog to digital. Digital TV has advantages such as an on-screen electronic program guide, hard drive recording, subtitles, digital radio, and interactive services. Now HD and 3D. High definition television or HD has up to 5 times the resolution of standard definition, either 1280x720 pixels or 1920x1080 pixels. A higher resolution picture has more lines and is much sharper, colorful, and more detailed. In the UK, broadcast through HD began in 2006. In the early 2010s, 3D television was being pushed as the next big viewing device. 3D TV failed to capture the public's imagination due to several reasons, like the audience had to wear glasses and you need to sit directly in front of the set to get the full benefit of 3D technology. Now smart TV. Now the television set has become smart. Smart TVs have built-in internet connectivity. This allows you to connect to a router, internet cable, or Wi-Fi dongle to get online. Now 4K better than HD. Ultra HD or 4K refers to a set having a minimum resolution of 3840x2160, that is 4 times as many pixels as Full HD and 8 times as many as HD. High resolution is in the amount of detail you will be able to see. With changing of time, people adapt the new technology of television. Now television has become one of the important mediums of entertainment with several popular shows. Television telecasting started in India on an experimental basis under All India Radio on September 15, 1959. It was an initiative of government. Due to limited transmission facility, people watched television 3 days a week. The programs were restricted to educational. At this initial stage, television was not considered to be a medium of entertainment. 180 teleclubs were set up within the range of 40 kilometers of the transmitter. In 1961, television programs for teachers were started. Regular broadcasting of television programs began in 1965. A daily one-hour service started during this year. By the 1970s, television centers were opened in other parts of the country also. Till 1976, Doordarshan was under the control of All India Radio. On that year, Doordarshan became a separate department. Now, Satellite Instructional Television Experiment, SIT. SIT was conducted in 1975-76 period in collaboration with NASA, the US Space Agency, and ISRO, the Indian Space Agency. In this experiment, American satellite ATS-6 was used. During the site, television reached to 2,400 villages of Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Orissa, and Rajasthan. Television sets were distributed in these states. This project was described as one of the largest communication experiments in the world. So here is a picture, a couple of pictures of people watching the programs of SIT and ATX. Now, the telecast happened twice a day, in the morning and evening. other than agriculture information, health and family planning, and entertainment like dance, music, drama, folk, and rural art forms were telecasted. Now, expansion of Doordarshan. Coverage of the 9th Asian Games in 1982 was the first time Doordarshan provided national coverage through the satellite InSat-1A. It was the first color transmission. Then DD installed nationwide transmitters for terrestrial broadcasting. By 1983, several new transmitters were set up throughout the country. A regular satellite link between Delhi and different other transmitters was established. During the end of 1980s, around 75% of the population could be covered by transmitters. During this period, no private enterprise has TV stations to transmit TV signals. On November 19, 1984, the second channel of Doordarshan was launched in New Delhi. On April 1, 1993, the Metro Entertainment Channel was started. Along with the domestic expansion, Doordarshan was also providing content to the telecasters of many other countries. After coverage of Asian Games, DD introduced and expanded the live coverage of sports like cricket, football, and hockey matches. Now, early programs of DD. Many mythological programs of Doordarshan like Ramayana and Mahabharata were immensely popular. Now, series like Hum Log in 1984 and Buniyad in 1986-87 period, and comedy shows like Ye Jo Hai Zindagi, then Nukat, along with spiritual shows such as Ramayana, then Mahabharata and Shaktiman were blockbusters. Hindi film songs based programs like Chitrahar, Rangoli, Ek Se Badke Ek and Superhit Mugabla, then crime thrillers like Karamchand, Abaradi Kaun, Byomkesh Bakshi, Dekhigat and Janki Jasus, children programs like Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, Tom and Jerry, then popular shows like Fauji, Rani Lakshmi Bai, Alif Laila, Vagle Ki Duniya, Tu Tu Me Me, Dekh Bhai Dekh, all catches the imagination of the viewers. Doordarshan website claims that more than 90% of Indian population can receive its programs. There are more than 1,416 terrestrial transmitters and about 67 Doordarshan studios telecasting TV programs. Doordarshan operates 26 satellite channels, including 16 regional language channels and 6 national channels. There are 12 state terrestrial networks functioning under DD. Emergence of private television channels. During the early 1990s, broadcast industry was liberalized. Many foreign players like Rupert Murdoch's Star TV network started its operation in 1991. Ted Turner's CNN started beaming news reports from Kuwait, where US-led forces was trying to flush out Iraqi invaders. Some cable operators added dishes and helped people watch CNN in their homes. It boosts the demand for cable TV. The trends of delivering satellite TV via cable moved into smaller towns from metros. Satellite improved the picture quality of television. In the early 90s, foreign programmers like CNN, followed by Star TV and domestic channels such as CTV and Sun TV telecast through satellite. Hong Kong-based Star ended with an Indian company and ZTV was born. It was the first privately owned Hindi satellite channel in India. As per the judgment, Supreme Court of India in 1995 declared airwaves are no longer a state monopoly. This also boosted the growth of private television channels. Regional channels like Sun TV in Tamil, Asianet in Malayalam and Ina TV in Telugu also started their telecasting during this period. Along with Indian language channels, international channels like CNN, BBC and Discovery are also active in India. Special religious channels, cartoon channels and movie channels available to the Indian viewers. Now, establishment of Prasar Bharati. As per Prasar Bharati Act 1990, state-owned telecaster Doordarshan and All India Radio function under the umbrella of Prasar Bharati. The Prasar Bharati Corporation was established to serve as a public service broadcaster of the country. It gives autonomy to the broadcasters as their management was left to a supervisory board. However, Prasar Bharati was not able to protect Doordarshan from government control. Now, various telecasting mediums. First, cable TV. Cable television is a system that distributes television signals by means of coaxial or fiber optic cables. These cable systems may use a community antenna to receive broadcast signals. Then the signals are retransmitted via cables to homes of the local area subscribers. Now, the conditional access system. CAS is a digital mode of transmitting TV channels through a set-top box. It gives the consumer's choice over the pay channels that are beamed into his home. It can be a solution to many challenges like an increase in prices, poor services, monopolies in each area, lack of regulatory framework, etc. Satellite television. Satellite television is a particular kind of telecast based on using space satellites to deliver signals. Telecast centers send broadcast signals to the satellites. After satellites receive the signals, it processes and sends back to earth dish antennas. Then by satellite receiver processes the signal and display on viewer's television set. Doordarshan, Star TV and Sony Entertainment Television, besides ZTV, Sun Network and Asianet, are satellite television. In the master list of Ministry of Information and Broadcasting as of 31st May 2016, the country has more than 880 permitted private satellite TV channels. Direct to home DTH service is provided by Airtel Digital TV, Big TV owned by Reliance, DD Direct Plus, Dish TV, Sun Direct DTH, Tata Sky and Videocon DTH. They use satellite like INSAT 4CR, INSAT 4A, INSAT 2E, INSAT 3C and INSAT 3E. Private satellites such as the Dutch-based SES Global, owned NSS6, Thaicom 2 and Telstar 10. Internet Protocol Television, IPTV. IPTV is the delivery of television content over computer networks based on the logical Internet protocol. The users can get services like video on demand, time shifting, digital recording, rewind or restart a live program already in progress. IPTV services are provided by Bharati Airtel in Delhi and Bengaluru, BSNL and MTNL through Akash OptiFiber and Smart TV Group. Now, IPTV market has a limited demand. Now, once television in India was started with all kinds of foreign support, for 3 decades, telecasting industry was completely controlled by government agency. Now, popular opinion is that television in India set the agenda for nation. Indian television originally confined to few communities, television sets of Delhi. Now expands its signal across the world. Of late, television assumes an industry status in India. Programs airs in diverse languages and forms. The bouquet on offer is an amalgamation of private and state-owned groups, which offers all kinds of entertainment and educational content. Survey claims that more than half of all Indian households own a television. From a small initiative by the British Broadcasting Corporation BBC in UK and the Columbia Broadcasting System CBS in USA, the telecasting has come a long way. From birds' fat cathode ray to the very thin plasma LCD, LED and the curved sets, technology has also traveled a whole lot of distance. So it has been almost a century of telecasting. So when we discuss about the technology and the content, we have to think about the difficulties and the problems it faced over the years. Now, if someone is asked that, will you be able to live without a serial, without a soap opera, without a film, or without some other news or current affairs related programs for a single day? The answer may be yes or no. If it is yes, that is true to the contest. And if he says no, and if we ask them why you are saying so, then the answer could be, I have a smartphone at my disposal. But remember, on your smartphone also, the television content is available. So you can browse through the content, watch it. There is no more a need of a television set or even a desktop or a laptop to watch the TV programs. That has been contracted to a small mobile. So television is content, telecasting, technology, everything has come a long way, and we too have traveled a long distance with this medium, and it has become an inevitable part of our life, to the extent that the pundits and those who are participating in national opinion formation are saying that media is setting the agenda for debates and discussion. So it is time to keep a tab on these developments and the technological progress. Tomorrow, nobody knows what could happen to this medium. It may become even smaller, but with an impact which will be far higher and wider than the one we experience over these years. So that's all about this episode of EPG Panchala. So thanks for watching it and listening to me patiently. Thank you very much.